If you want to learn how to make your Blue Snowball go from
sounding like this to sounding like this
using only free software, then you've come to the right place. I'm Pete from the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, where we have videos explaining everything you need to do to grow your gaming passion into your profession. And today, I'm going to be talking you through all the settings and software that you need to make your Blue microphone sound as professional and production ready as possible. So in this video, we're only going to be using free software. If, however, you're looking for a guide that uses Adobe Audition CC to improve the quality of your microphone, I have got a guide on that as well, which I'll link up in the card above, as well as in the description below, where I'll be putting all the links for this video today. Let's get into it. The programs that we are using today actually adapt the sound of your microphone on the fly. So you can sound that way while streaming, recording voiceovers, or even to talking to somebody on Skype. The two programs that you're going to need are both made by a company called VB Audio, and they are called Virtual Cable and Voicemeeter. If you click the two links in the video description below, you'll be taken to the website where you can download both of them. Firstly, for Virtual Cable, scroll down until you see the orange download button and click that. Whilst that's downloading, you can click the second link for Voicemeeter, and if you scroll down again to the bottom of the page, you'll see the download. You can download the zip package again. Once they both finish downloading, you should have two zip files in your downloads folder. Extract both zip files using whatever software you use. I use 7-zip, so I can just extract files here. We're going to install the virtual cable software first. So if you open up the unzipped folder, and then depending on whether you're using a 64-bit operating system or a 32-bit operating system, you need to run one of these two files as administrator. On Windows 10, you can just right-click the Start menu, go to System, and it will tell you right there which operating system you're using. You can see here I'm using 64-bit operating system. So since I'm using 64-bit, I'm going to run this file as administrator. If you're using 32, run this one. This is going to open up a new window, and you just click Install Driver. You're going to get a pop-up saying you may need to reboot your system to finalize installation. That's okay. We're going to reboot after we've installed both pieces of software. Next, we're going to install the Voicemeeter program. So head back to your extracted folder and open up the Voicemeeter setup file. Run that as administrator as well. It's going to open up a similar window. Just click install. You'll get another pop-up telling you that you must reboot your system to finalize installation, and it'll open a new window in your browser just thanking you for installing. We'll go ahead now and reboot our system so that both programs can function properly. Now that we've restarted our system, we can open up the Voicemeeter application by just searching for it in the Start menu. Your window may look a little bit different to this when you open up Voicemeeter. This is just because it's loaded my default settings since I already had the application installed. What I have done is I've uploaded my settings into my Dropbox so that you guys can download them, and then that'll give you a good baseline to work from, and then you can play around with settings then. So if you look in the description and download the third file, which is my settings from my Dropbox, I'll then show you how to load the settings into Voicemeeter for you to then adapt. If you finish the download, click Menu, Load Settings, and locate the settings file that you just downloaded. Click Open, and it should start to look a little bit more like this. Don't worry if the bars here aren't going up, because we just need to configure the hardware input and hardware output devices to make sure it's picking up your microphone. Firstly, we'll set the input. If you come up here to where it says 1 and click the down arrow, you're going to get all your different microphone inputs. If you have a Blue Yeti or a Blue Snowball here, it should probably come up with the name. For some reason on Windows, mine doesn't, but I know that this is my Blue Snowball or Blue Yeti. So select the microphone here on hardware input. And up here where it says A1, we want to be setting the cable input, so the VB Audio virtual cable. Now you should start to see the bars moving as you speak into your microphone. If you haven't loaded my settings, then you can attempt to mimic the settings here. By muting certain tracks and making sure stereo repeat is selected, but I really do recommend just downloading my settings and then playing with it from there. If you want to play around with the compressor effects to change the sound of your voice, you're going to be moving this little red box around the graph here. The setting I have here makes it sound a bit bassier and like something you will hear from a podcast, but feel free to drag this around to wherever you want to. Now, at this stage, it's worth mentioning that whenever you want your microphone to be sounding like this, you need to have Voicemeeter running. So don't forget to start it if you start streaming, recording your voiceover, or if you want to sound like this on TeamSpeak or Skype, make sure you have Voicemeeter running. You're also going to need to make sure that whichever software you're using to record your voice or send your voice across the internet, that you have it set up to be picking up the right microphone. And the trick here is it's not meant to be picking up your Blue Snowball or Blue Yeti. It's actually meant to be picking up the Voicemeeter output. To demonstrate this, I'll open up Audacity. So in whichever program you're using to record your voice, or if you're using OBS, make sure you set it there. You want to make sure that your microphone setting here is set to the Voicemeeter output. If you have this set to your Blue Snowball, it's not going to be applying any of the vocal effects to make your microphone actually sound good. So I'm going to quickly demonstrate here the difference between having Voicemeeter and not having Voicemeeter on. Firstly, I'll record just from the microphone.
This is how my mic sounds without Voicemeeter running.
And now I'll change to using Voicemeeter.
And this is how my mic sounds with Voicemeeter running.
Let's listen to them back.
This is how my mic sounds without Voicemeeter running. And this is how my mic sounds with Voicemeeter running.
Hopefully you could hear the difference between those two, and you can play around with the Voicemeeter settings to really make sure that you're getting the sound out of it that you want. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching. If you found the video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, because that helps us know which kind of content you guys enjoy. We can make more of it in the future. Also, if you're new here to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, have a look around. We've got loads of videos helping you grow your YouTube channel, grow your Twitch audience, and generally turn your gaming passion into a profession. If that's the kind of content that you guys enjoy, then be sure to click subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace.